Hi fam. So I wanted to take a second and shoot this because I first off want to let you know that the footage you are about to see was not intended to be aired. I came to Mama Mai over an issue that we recently had, but it went very left. It was one of those situations where it's too family, where you're, you know, almost embarrassed about anybody ever seeing this. But as I talked to friends and family about what happened between Mama Mai and I learned very quickly that I'm not the only one experiencing this. I didn't know what to do when people you love don't respect COVID boundaries the way you do. I realized this is something we have to talk about. We have made a promise to keep things completely unfiltered for you guys. Everything you've ever seen is always Mama Mai and I the way we are. But if you love us at our best, you gotta understand when we're at our worst. Just letting you know that this is part one. Mama Mai and I today are still working through what you're about to see. But the whole point of sharing this with you is to hopefully have an open dialogue of what do you do when you have this problem with your family members or with your loved ones, and that you're not alone, and that we will figure out the best resolution because we all love each other too much to let each other be hurt or be misunderstood. Love you guys.
It's been over a month and we have not talked at all. If I call her, she's gonna think I'm apologizing, and I'm not apologizing.
That's a great way to go into it.
If we call her in front of you, she will feel forced to stay and actually confront the problem, which she doesn't do. And hopefully she'll be more factual.
Well, will you be open to hearing maybe what you did wrong in this too?
No, because there's nothing I did wrong.
Great. Okay. That's a great way to start. I'm going to get her. Hi, Mama. So you'll talk to Jeannie. I'm going to send you a Zoom link. Okay. Put the phone down because she's here. Be nice.
Hello.
Hi, Mama.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
How come I don't see anybody? I don't see my face.
That's the God punish you.
You have to turn your video on, Mama.
Okay. How can I turn on the video, Mama Mai? Hold on. Take it easy, Mew. The host asking you to start a video. Yes, start video. Okay, yes, I can see my face now.
Turn it sideways. Yeah, can you do that? Is that okay?
Sure. I want to make sure I'm okay.
Yeah, you look beautiful.
Always.
Jeannie told me that you two had a little bit of a disagreement.
Yes, I do.
Are you all three of us?
Yeah. Include the devil. Yes. I can see the devil right here.
What did you call me?
Devil. Whatever. Go ahead. Okay.
Do you want to tell me what happened?
No, I'm starting first.
Okay. What happened over the holidays?
This woman right here. This face right here.
The Mama Mai.
Yeah.
That's my name.
We all know who you are. I have not talked to her since Christmas. Over a month because of this fight we had. Probably the biggest we've had for a while. Am I right?
You asking me?
Yeah, I'm asking you.
That's you start a fire. You are the one start a fire, not me.
So Jay and I and my whole family, we decided to cancel Christmas, which normally, you know, the family, we all come together for Christmas. There's over 30 people in the house. Obviously, because of COVID, it's not safe to have that type of a Christmas. So instead, me and Jay decided to fly to Napa so that we could see just my mom and my dad, only see the necessary family, and then that's it. Rosalina, who has been in a prior episode of Hello Hunnay, she said, guys, I've never been able to celebrate your engagement. I want to throw you an engagement dinner just for you guys. Me, G. Rosie, her husband Marty, my mom, my dad, go hang, me and Jay. Perfect quarantine group. That's it. 8 people. So I find out from G. Rosie. She says, Jeannie, I only am telling you this because I don't want you to be surprised when you come, but your mom has decided to invite some other friends. I'm just letting you know. I say, who else would be there besides main family? Because it's an engagement dinner. There doesn't need to be any other people there. Jay and I don't really want to be around other people, A, for COVID safety, and B, because it's an engagement dinner, so it's private. I call Mama Mai. And she says, don't worry. What you talk about? That's just my friend. You don't worry. You too nosy. It's going to be safe. And don't worry about it. Click. I text her. I don't care who you're bringing because the people that I just named are all that matters. We don't need anybody else there. Come Christmas. Jay and I roll up. We've got a nice little gift for Rosalina. We're ready to celebrate our engagement dinner. Our engagement dinner. Family only. We walk in and all of a sudden, camera, taking pictures all over the place. My dad is there. Gohang is there. Jirozi's there. Everybody else is there. But like at least four people that I don't recognize. And already I'm like, oh God. Okay, who is this? So Mama Mai's like, hello. Oh my God, my daughter. I'm so happy to see you. And her friends who are excited, nice people, I'm sure. They also come towards me and they're like super excited. I don't know these people. I think my mom has mentioned that I met them in the past before, which is cool, but they're not people that I would need to be at a private engagement dinner or during COVID. They're not my quarantine. I don't know anything about them. So we do the whole dinner, beautiful engagement dinner, by the way. Insert picture here of the cake. Oh my God, Rosalina gave us a cake with the exact box of my ring and the ring itself. It was stunning. So the next day, my mom comes over to our house in Napa to hang out. And I want to talk to her immediately because Lord forbid she goes and does this continuously with other friends, hanging out with people that she doesn't know have been quarantined or not. And then she gets COVID and she's my vulnerable. This woman right here, she's the one that we have to be careful for. And she doesn't get it. As soon as she walks into the house, I see her and I go, Mom, I need to talk to you. Last night really upset me. I asked for a private engagement dinner. It was just supposed to be us. You invited these friends that I specifically told you, I don't know, and I don't want to be there. They're great people. I'm sure they're your friends, but no, I don't think you should have done that. Now, what I didn't realize is that behind me, my dad was there and Gohang was there. So my mom looks at me and she's like, why are you saying this in front of people? She walks out on me. I chase after her and she's like, you do not talk to me like that in front of people. You do not yell at me in front of other people. And I'm like, okay, sure, I get that, but this is important. She gets mad and turns off, walks away. We're supposed to go have lunch together, all of us as a family. So we start to go get ready to have lunch. My mom says, no, I'm not going. This is the thing I hate. I hate that she does, is when she gets mad, she turns off everything. She'll cancel Christmas, which by the way, you have canceled Christmas. You'll cancel Christmas and make everybody else suffer, even though it's just your fault. She asks Dennis to drive her home from Napa, which is like 2.5-3 hours. She just wants to leave, which is going to make everybody now feel terrible because she wants to go home. It's time for our lunch reservation. I look at the one innocent bystander. I said, Jay, will you talk to my mom? But if you don't get through to her, let's go. And he says, because he's loyal to Mama Mai, no, I'm not leaving my mom here. I'm going to stay and talk to her. So I said, I'm going. I don't care. We're at lunch. Lunch is being served. Jay's not there. 20 minutes go by, 30 minutes go by, 45 minutes go by. They're not there. I keep texting Jay. What's going on? If she doesn't want to come, it's fine. Leave her. Let's go. He doesn't answer my texts. An hour and a half later, after lunch is done, a car pulls up. Out pops Jay and my mom. And my mom's like, hi, everybody. Hello, Hunnay. I'm so glad we're here. The whole table, everybody's like, oh my God, Mama Mai, I'm so happy you're here. We're so glad. And I'm sitting there like, are you serious? We get through the lunch. I talked to Jay that night. He's kind of like, what she did was wrong. But you could have talked to her at a better time so that everybody didn't hear. And I'm like, okay, whatever. But we're talking about health safety here. So I'm sorry, but not sorry. We go to now having dinner at our house. Everybody's in the house. The next day, I think about it and I'm like, it's Christmas. And you know what? I don't want my mom and I to have this funk. I'm gonna go ahead and tell my mom that I am sorry for bringing it up in front of people because I get it. Like, it didn't need that. I find her in a hallway and I'm like, can I just talk to you for a second? No, I don't talk to you. I don't have to say anything to you. You'll forget it and never talk to you again. And walks away. And I'm like, okay, so now you're going to be petty about it. As I'm trying to resolve things for the holidays, you're going to be this person. So since then, I have never talked to my mom since. Can you please see why I have a right to be mad? comment below.
Like, you think you're right. You think you're right the whole
1,000%. Just comment below, please. Jeannie wins. Like, okay, fine, not Jeannie wins, but Jeannie is right. Please just put those letters for me down. Please just put that down.
Mama, how do you feel?
I feel she's wrong the whole time, but she doesn't even realize what she's wrong. Rosalina wants to make the Christmas party with the family. And I told her I have 2 couples. I love them. I like them. I would like to invite because most of the time my daughter, she always invite her friend to come over. But she never invite my friend to come over. I only invite 2 couples to come over. That's all. One of the couple, they know Jeannie for a long time, but Jeannie don't remember. Or Jeannie forget. That's fine. They don't know what we're doing. They thought they come for Christmas party. They don't know we'll do engagement for Jeannie's separate family only.
Did you know that it was like an engagement dinner?
I combine together Christmas party and you know what? Because I'm trying to do Christmas party. You come in like, you know, like a you surprise. You make a big deal of it. She say, Mom, they don't go out that much. They don't go celebrate party to any place else. They do special that day for me because they think I come for Christmas and then I'm gonna go back to LA or go back to Houston. They come over here for me, not for you. But Rosalina do it for you. The next day, we go to Napa. She's still nagging. I don't know who she look like. Maybe look like me or whatever. But
100%, I got my whole
attitude. When I walk in the door, as soon as I walk in the door, you yell at me in front of Papa, my girlfriend, in front of Dennis, embarrass me. What kind of daughter is that? Are you my daughter or you are my mom? I'm confused at that time. We just walk in the door, you yelling right away. You don't even say, hello, how you doing? How you feel? How you arrive in the car? Nothing at all. You just wait for me to come in and you start a fire. You over here, I'm over here. I don't care you know, about celebrity. I don't care you celebrity. All I care, you are my daughter. Why you yelling at me in front to Papa Mai and in front to Jeannie? You make him feel bad too. You screw up the whole thing, everyone upset. So you think I'm the one make the people upset? No, you are the one. GJ, he's generous. He won't let me go home. He keep talk about the weather, talk about cooking, talk about whatever, talk everything. He used a Kylo G with me. Forget about them. Here, you and me, shake, and drinking whatever. He don't care about you guys at all, okay? That's how he used a Kylo G with me. That's a very smart guy. Really cool, you know, like not cool the gang. Cool, really, how to say in English? Soft and cool. Calm, too calm, okay? So finally, I go because of him. That's why I came. It's not because of you.
Okay, and then?
And then when you cook something breakfast, right? And go hang, that's Papa, my girlfriend, asked me, why don't you try your daughter's food to see how is it? I say, why should I try her food? The one I'm so upset, the one make me get mad. Why should I eat her food for? I don't need to eat her food. I eat cup noodle. I feel good myself. That's how I say it.
That's why you ate the cup of noodle? Dude, this is
That's why I make my own.
This is so
why I make my own food.
I made a whole breakfast spread: pancakes, egg frittata, shrimp egg frittata.
Uh-huh.
Those amazing blueberry pancakes for everybody. She sits down in front of my beautiful brunch spread. Can we come sit for breakfast, please?
Yeah, this is my egg for my noodle.
Oh my God, get it off the table.
Right
off the table.
Wow, thank you. So good.
And brings a couple noodles that she brought from home to sit there and eat her stupid noodles just to prove a point that she didn't want to eat my breakfast.
I want you to feel guilty.
I didn't feel guilty. I loved it. Thank you for leaving me extra
pancakes. Well, how can you feel guilty with the devil?
So happy I had extra pancakes.
You are devil. That's why you don't feel guilty. If you are a human being, you feel guilty. Why I did my mom
should feel
like
guilty
that?
About this. Then you should feel guilty about this. Why is it that when I tried to say sorry to you, when I tried
hold on.
Apologize. Okay. Then you should feel guilty because you made all of the holidays off.
Jeannie, what do you think?
You didn't want to let us wash it.
If you see somebody, you put the water on their face, splash on their face like that, and you say, oh, I'm sorry. You didn't go like that? No. You start a fire, and I'm not going to let you get away from it because you are my daughter. You over here. I'm over here. I don't care. You're a celebrity. In my house, you still under me. If you feel guilty, you say sorry, you should come to tell me beginning. You're not going to walk out of the door for the party and let GJ come talk to me. Remember that. If you feel guilty, at that time,
No, I don't feel guilty because I'm quarantining right now. Do you see this house? There's nobody around me. I really do seriously quarantine, Mom. I have 100% right to be angry about somebody who doesn't take quarantine safely. You put Rosalina in danger. You put my dad in danger. You put Jay in danger. He has a kid. Like, that's too much. So I'm right about that.
Jeannie, to you, you think you're right. What about my friend? They live here and they don't go to party that much. They see both of you, they're scared too because both of you fly from LA.
They don't come to the party.
No. They don't come. They worry about your guy too. You know what I'm talking about? You think about that. You think about your side, but you don't think about the other side.
No.
They drive in the car to come to the party. You fly on the way here. Think about that.
Exactly. So don't come. People who should come are the people who trust each other. All I know.
That's why I trust each other. I trust them. That's why I bring those over there. Now we do the show like this. I don't know how they're gonna feel, how they're gonna think. You know what I mean?
There's nothing they did wrong. They just should have not been there.
You the one should not been there, not them.
At my
engagement. We invited people, no fly.
At my engagement dinner. Can you at least accept that both of us are wrong here? You were wrong for bringing extra people to a quarantine party. That is what you're wrong about. I am wrong because I shouldn't have made a big deal out of it and whatever, said things to you in front of other people. I should have waited or maybe talk to you about it privately. I shouldn't talk to you like that in front of other people. And I admit that. I apologize about that. That is wrong. Can we at least admit that that's two people's faults?
Yes, you're more bigger than me. You're more fault than me. The only thing is you don't know them. You don't know because we have no time to talk about it. You don't know that's how.
Until COVID is over, I don't want to see anybody else. I haven't seen my friends. Shelly, I haven't seen her for almost a year now, Mom. Paul has not even shot Hello Hunnay. We're doing this because I'm shooting everything by myself.
I know, I agree about that. Yes.
So if you notice, if I'm taking it that seriously with people like Paul and Shelly, my good friends, the real, our whole show, I haven't seen Adrian, Lonnie, Garcelle, nobody. So you have to imagine, I don't want to see your random friends that I don't know. No shade, Mom. After COVID, if we're alive, we can all see each other. But right now, no, we don't need that. We ruined Christmas. Christmas.
You are the one ruining the whole Christmas. I don't do anything. You are the one, you know, start a fire from A to Z. I don't do anything.
You have to own fault. What you did is what made me mad to then have to have a fight with you about it. And then you carried it on all past Christmas and do dumb things like eat cup of noodle when we're starting to have breakfast together because you're petty. She made our Christmas canceled last year. We had a whole Christmas where my aunt and my uncle weren't there. If the fire's this big, you make it even worse because you then, I don't want to go. I will never talk to you again. And then all of a sudden everything gets canceled because of you. Can we call Dennis, Paul?
Yeah, I can get him if you want me to.
Yes.
I can't believe it. The year 2021, we still carry the old year to the new year.
Who's
carrying on the new year?
Carrying it. Who's carrying it? Who's carrying it?
You are.
No, you are.
Put your clothes on.
Could we put on a shirt for this?
Can you put your shirt on, Dennis? What's the matter with you?
Oh, and some chapstick might help too. So glad you could join us, Dennis. Are you wearing pants?
Oh,
put your clothes, put your shirt on.
Never.
Hey, this right. is not so, summer time. This is the winter time.
So Jay was so, okay, we're good. We talked about what happened at Christmas. I want to hear who you think is at what?
Nothing. Wait, is this recording?
Yes.
Yeah. Put your clothes on.
No, it's fine. From your take, whose fault do you think it was that made Christmas totally ruined because of their pettiness?
Language.
And please take the, Dennis, start talking.
When that happened, I told her that you yell at me all the time. You yell at me all the time in front of people. And I just take it, okay? Right? I just do it. And then she said, it's not the same though. You're younger than her. I'm much older than her. And then I was like, oh, okay. Yeah, that's our operating system. That's how we roll.
Okay, that is not okay though. It's not right.
I told you, dude. She's like the child in the family. You know what I mean? We're like, mom, no phones at the table. Come on, we're having dinner.
Are you listening to your son right now?
So I am.
Tell your mother right here. Tell her what she needs to work on, because we're sick and tired of dealing with it's my way or the highway. And then everything's canceled because of her mood. You almost had to drive her home from Napa, which ruins your Christmas plans, your relationship with her, because if you didn't want to do it, then now you get in trouble.
Dennis, what do you think when
she... Tell her how she's wrong.
When I walked in the house, she yelled at me. What do you think? You shocked too. Papa, am I shocked too? Because that time she yelling. What do you think?
Honestly, mom, I think you're out of control. I think you're out of control. I think all this Hello Hunnay has made your head so big that, you know, your fams and all the comments and all the people talking to you has made you think like you're like Trump or something. like you can say whatever you want on Twitter. All right. And now we got to pull the plug.
Are you talking about me? Are you talking about Jeannie?
She doesn't know who she's talking to. Explain it, Dennis. Explain it to her again. Say it again.
I do feel her head has gotten way too big.
No, Dennis, don't say
her. Who's too big? Me or Jeannie?
Oh, that's mom of mine.
Dennis, explain to mom. Say to mom, because she thinks you're talking about someone else. Mom, you start there.
Mom.
What? I don't want to see your nipple.
Mom.
Go ahead. What?
I think your head. We can't talk to you anymore, mom. You can't take criticism anymore. You think you're like a god or something.
And by the way, even your sister said so. Mama Mai has become too big here. Like,
that's
too big
true.
Like this. Too ego. And now you don't think about people's feelings. When you're wrong, you're not wrong because you're Mama Mai.
No, you're wrong. You're wrong. That's the way I born. That's the way I am already for a long, long time.
Well, it's gotten worse.
I know. That's the way I am all the time. That's the way I'm born already. If you think I'm really stuck up, okay? I don't talk to you at all, Jeannie. I'm going to keep the way I am. I will not talk to you until, you know, you're going to bend down and bow me and sorry to me.
No.
That's me. Otherwise, okay, because I'm not stuck up, that's why I'm still talking to you.
Don't make this crazy, Mom. I apologize for talking to you in a rude way. And in a confrontational way that could have waited, I could have talked to you in private. But no, Mom, I'm not saying this. If your family is saying this, they're saying it. You can't be so unfair. This is people's health. And that's something that's serious to me.
I feel like there's a lot that we've talked about today. And Mama, I can tell you're hurting too. And I feel like there maybe should be a point where like this conversation continues with somebody else that might be able to help out in a way that you can both be heard.
You know, very funny about this.
What happened to her sound? Why is your sound different?
I'm thinking different already.
No, your sound, your audio is messed up now.
Try to leave and come back in,
leave
Mama,
and come back because your sound is weird. No. Mom, no.
How do you want? I need to come back.
Yes. Now it's better. Okay, go.
What happened?
Oh my God.
It worked. Why? What happened?
Nothing. Go.
That's funny.
No. Come back.
Okay. You are not wrong about it. We should have less people or no people. I agree with you 100%. But I'm trying to tell you, the people I'm hanging out with, they don't go party. They don't go nowhere.
Mom, I don't want to make this about your friends because they don't know. They're innocent in this. But remember, one of the couples, after they were done with our party, where did they go, Mom? They went to another party. Quarantine means look like this. Nobody. No employee, nothing. Nobody.
Only 6 or 7 people. That's all. What the hell are you talking about?
Look at me.
No, Mom.
Mom, I am sorry that I spoke to you like that because I know that was wrong. I care about you, Mom. And right now, I am scared. COVID is affecting everybody. And I don't want to lose you, Mom. I don't want to lose Dad. It could take one person getting sick. I'm just concerned about you. And that's why I brought it up.
I'm telling you, okay? The COVID take you for 2 weeks to die. right? When I talk to you, take me 1 minute to die. You make me get a heart attack. I die faster than COVID. Let me tell you that. I can get stroke right there.
So that's why
that I'm already- easy to get stroke.
So I've already said, I apologize about that, Mom. I've said it like 5 times now. I apologize about that and I'm sorry about it. But more than the yelling, I'm just saying, I'm worried for Dad and you. I'm worried and I don't want to see you guys get sick.
Don't worry, I stay away from you. I feel more healthy, more happiness.
Fine, Mom, fine.
And have a long life too.
Great, Mom, happy. I'm so happy for you.
Whatever. You can have a wedding without Mama Mai.
Okay, perfect.
So what do you think?
Doing it again, Mom.
You do the same thing I'm just talking to you about right now. Now you make it even worse. That's fine, Mom. If you don't want to come, that's okay. That's fine. Now you make it worse.
Don't do what she's doing.
I'm not. I'm just saying she's the one who's saying, I'm not even talking about the wedding. What does that have to do with anything?
Whatever. You try to say my head up high. You're thinking about I'm the Mama Mai. I'm thinking blah, 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 blah.
I didn't say any of that, Mom. Why don't you listen? Did I say any of that?
The way you guys think like
that. Your sister said it, not me, okay?
Whatever. I feel like you're the one. I think you are the one, not me.
Where am I saying that? I'm the one who made the show, Mom. What are you talking about? Why would I say that?
No, I feel like you think you're stuck up, that's why you think you have more power to yell.
I don't have, I think I'm stuck up. I'm trying to tell you right now, I already apologized.
You say, Paul? Yeah, okay, she apologized to me now in front of the television. She say, you didn't.
Because I'm angry, Mom, I just told you I'm sorry, and now you keep pushing it. I'm like, I don't even know what you want anymore.
You don't have to do anything. You keep the way you are. I don't trust you anything. You can see that, Paul? You see, if the person apologizes.
Make me happier, go do that, Mom. I'm fine. I'm so fine. So good. I celebrate you, Mom. Everything I do, I always like. Wherever I go and I share things about you, even if I do my own show and my own, like, whether it's Dancing with the Stars or I get an opportunity like this, I always share you. I agree.
I know you do a good thing.
I would be much happier.
That's why you should.
But we just try to talk to you about this and you don't even want to try to make it better. You're going to be like, why? The very person you don't like who's alone right now. Your family has to send him money because nobody wants to go over there and see him. Nobody wants to. You're going to be just like that. Just so you know. I don't want that in my family. I don't want to be like that. So if that means separating from you so I have a more peaceful life, I'm fine with that, Mom. You make me sad and I don't want that, but if you separate from me, that's it, then that's fine.
I'm there to tell you.
It doesn't even have anything to do with the wedding, but you make someone else's wedding your problem now. You make someone else's wedding, you are the problem. So you're the one to say, I don't want to be there. Nobody's even talking about that. And I've already apologized about Christmas, but you're making it now about you. This is what you do. So that's fine.
I make up my mind already at that night. No matter what
you're making up your mind about what? You can stick to it and be fine. You can stick to
it. Keep it the way it is. I know what I'm doing.
What are you talking about? Keep what the way it is?
I will not hang out with you anymore because I don't want you to jump anytime. Even right now, you apologize to me, turn around, you say you, something like that.
Mom, I didn't even say you. Don't lie. I did not. I did not say that. Don't lie. It's on camera. I did not say that.
Dennis, Paul, do you hear what she say?
No, I did not say you. Why the hell would I say that? I've never said that in my life. Don't make up stories.
Why don't we all just stop cussing in front of Mom because she doesn't like that, so.
Well, that's fine, but I'm saying, I'm trying to say I'm sorry. I've said it 5 different times and you've never even said sorry 1 time about bringing so many people. You never even said 1 time. You made everybody uncomfortable. Everybody was uncomfortable.
You're the only one, Jeannie. You're the one start a fire. You're the one uncomfortable. Everybody happy. They very comfortable. I can tell.
Glad we had this talk. We're fine. That's it. I tried to call you to apologize. You just never, always remember this. Always remember this. If this is the last time I talk to you, always remember that I tried to apologize to you and you completely just want to start a fight. You want to keep fighting and that's fine.
You make a lot of things nice to me. You make everything for me to proud about me. You're, on television or YouTube or Facebook, whatever. The people know how much you love me, you care for me. But one day, you know, you yelling at me, you screaming at me in front of the people, same thing.
Apologize for that already.
Listen, hold on. Look like a, you step on my face like that, okay?
I already apologized for that.
I want you to learn something. Whatever, you make a good thing, and then if you do one little thing, you screw up the whole thing.
Great. I already apologized, so if you don't accept it, I don't know what else to do, Mom. I
will not accept it, no matter what. I keep in my mind, never accept it.
Yeah, just like your dad. So now you create a generation. You and your dad don't talk, and now you and your daughter don't talk. Perfect, Mom. Good job. Good job. You don't want a relationship with me. That's fine. That's totally fine. I don't think that you, to be honest, you always criticize me. You always have things to say. You're not happy with most of the things I do. So that's fine. You probably don't even want a daughter like me. So then that's fine. Cut it off. You're great. I hope you're happy.
I'm happy right now. I am.
Good. Great. Great. That's perfect. So we're good.
Okay. I'm going to stop this and I think we'll take a break and hopefully I'll can regroup at some point.
How can she embarrass me, especially that part of my girlfriend?
I think Jeannie's anger that day was based on that feeling of helplessness that we all have right now. She is that scared about what this illness is and what it could do. We don't know how to talk about this. It's a pandemic. We can't hug each other. We can't take care of each other the way we used to. And it's making us all crazy.